Today we are joined by scientist and engineer Hal Walker. Hal, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you. Glad to be here.
You worked a lot with lasers. Can you tell us what is a laser?
A laser, the word laser, light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. Now everybody heard that, so remember it.
So what does that actually mean?
That means what you've done is put together a system that involves power supplies, involved optical components, and of course you have to have a laser medium, which in our case was ruby crystals.
Now during Apollo 11, you actually fired a laser at the moon. Mm-hmm. Tell us about that.
Wow. One of the things we wanted to learn from the Apollo 11 mission, using a laser rangefinder, is how far away the moon is to an accuracy that would make a new state of the art. Previously using radar, but the distance was down to maybe about 200 or 300 meters. We could now go to inches. So this is what our purpose was.
We've got a little demonstration here. We've got our
yes.
globe, and I've got a laser tape measure.
Wonderful.
And across the room, we have a little moon globe that's approximately to the scale of the size and the distance.
Okay.
And so we're going to take this and we're going to put it about where California is, because you fired the laser from
Lick Observatory in Northern California.
All right. So we're going to fire our laser beam here, and we're going to hit the moon.
Wow.
And take a reading. And is that kind of similar to what you all did?
That's exactly what we did. And the idea, again, using the speed of light, was to send the beam, hit the reflector, have the light come back to us, sense its return, measure the time it took, and now by that calculation, we could tell how far away it was, 240,000 miles away, give or take something.
And why was that important to know?
Let's say, one of the things that we had never been able to understand as part of Albert Einstein's theory of relativity is how these two objects interplay with each other. So the laser rangefinder gave us a way to test that. And of course, one of the other very important things was we felt, and maybe it's still some of the things that we see happen in the future, we could watch the Earth's plates move around, shift on the Earth by using a reflector as a stable platform and watch ourselves move relative to it.
And it also gives us a way to very vividly test that humans were on the moon.
Yes, I spent most of my life saying that.
Can we still use this reflector today?
Yeah, those reflectors are still there and still usable today. And of course, as you may be familiar with, they just concluded 40 years of ranging experiments utilizing the lasers at McDonald Observatory just in the past couple of years.
Well, thank you so much for talking with us today.
Thank you.
Let us know what you thought of this video down in the comments section. And if you enjoyed it, be sure to give it a like and a share. And follow STEM in 30 on Facebook and Twitter, and subscribe to the National Air and Space Museum's YouTube channel.